Every 4 years, Democrats and Republicans gather in the summer to formally nominate their candidate for president. Why do they do this? And what happens when they get there? Let's get the facts on conventions. First, what are conventions? Conventions are where parties formally nominate their presidential and vice presidential candidates. But here's the thing. That's where the nominating process ends. It actually starts at the primaries. That's because when voters select their choice for president, what's really happening is they're helping each candidate win delegates, who in turn
votes for the first woman,
promise to vote for that candidate at the convention. Now, a candidate needs to reach a magic number of delegates to win their party's nomination. And if they reach that number, the process at the convention can be pretty simple and straightforward. And then they've got enough committed delegates to win the nomination on the first ballot of voting. But if a candidate does not get enough delegates on the first round of voting to become the nominee, then we have what's called a brokered convention. It's called that because before the parties use primaries to award delegates, quote, power brokers would get together, negotiate, and persuade delegates to vote for the candidate of their choice, that is, until a nominee was selected. But for both parties, there hasn't been a brokered convention in more than 70 years. Now, picking the presidential candidate is not the only thing on the agenda at a convention. That's also where the parties develop their plans for the country for the next 4 years, if they get elected. This is also known as the party platform. Political parties aren't in the Constitution. In fact, Congress selected presidential candidates until 1830. Over the years, that process has evolved into our current two-party system and the creation of the nominating conventions we have today. Helping you get the facts, I'm Christopher Salas.